In this video, we're going to talk about something that you've probably never heard about in React, and that is owner components. Owner components are something that used to be prevalent in the early days of React, literally like almost even before my time, and now not so much in the recent days. However, they are making a comeback, and they are very important, especially in the world of server components. Now, before we get into that, I just want to mention that if you're looking to learn React and actually learn how to build a real project, a project that's complex, big, has a lot of moving parts, definitely check out Project React in the description. I promise you, you will not regret it. All right, so this is a very interesting article. There's a lot of really cool lessons to learn on here, and I genuinely enjoyed reading this. This is written by Brad Westfall, and it's actually an article that we had in our newsletter. So if you didn't know, I have a newsletter. It's called Import React. It's completely free. You get it to your inbox every single week, and you get articles like this and other really cool, interesting ones completely for free. So if you want to join, honestly, it's a no-brainer. It makes total sense. Check it out. It's going to be also linked in the description. So now we're going to read React owner components. Owners versus parents, and why it matters for server components and client components. So let's begin. In React, the term owner can be used to describe a component in the hierarchy, similar to using the term parent. It's somewhat of a lost term that I almost never see newer React developers use anymore. The term was used more heavily in the early days of React and is still useful today, especially when it comes to understanding client components versus server components, right? Server components are the new thing, the new craze, and most probably the future of React. So understanding the difference between an owner component, a parent component, and a client component, and now a server component is really, really important. I promise you, this article makes it really simple, and I'm going to do my best to also add my commentary to make it even more simpler. Let's jump straight to an example which describes it best. So here we have the user profile, we have const user set user as state, this is an empty object, and then we have a div and a span. This is literally, as far as component goes, one of the simplest components that you can have. In this example, we would say that div is a parent and span is the child, right? So that's fair. We have div over here, this is the parent, and the child of div is this span over here, right? No surprises there. JSX uses the same parent-child terminology that is used in HTML or XML. Now let's rewrite this with components. So here you have the same component, user profile, same state over here, but now we have profile layout and then avatar, right? Profile layout is the parent and avatar is the child. We didn't change much about the hierarchy. Profile layout is the parent and avatar is the child. The owner component, however, is user profile, right? So that's different. Parent, child, and then owner. User profile is the owner, right? And here's why. An owner component owns the JSX of another component and can pass props into it. That is very specific. That is very important, actually. Owner components own the JSX of other components and can pass props into those components. Notice that user profile could pass the user state as props into profile layout and avatar if we wanted to, right? So we have the state over here. We're free to pass this inside of profile layout and avatar as we wish, right? That's what we can do. This is what makes the user profile an owner. The fact that it creates the JSX of these other components and passes props onto them. In the hierarchy, user profile and profile layout are above the avatar, but we have separate words for them because they are not the same. A parent component cannot pass props into the child. In our example above, profile layout is the parent of avatar and it receives it as a child, therefore it cannot pass props. Therefore its relationship to avatar is parent-child, not owner-child, right? So here, this is the example of the profile layout component. We're receiving children over here, right? We're receiving the actual avatar. This children over here is actually this avatar here, but we cannot pass props directly onto it because it's children. We don't pass props to children this way. The only person that can pass the props is the user profile component, and that's why it's the owner component. Parents don't re-render their children. You're probably aware that React can create a cascade of re-renders, right? React is all about re-rendering, so this is pretty typical. When an owner component re-renders, it will re-render all of the components that it owns. That's also very important. However, this is not true of parent components. In our example, if user profile re-renders for any reason, it will re-render both the profile layout and the avatar because it owns them, right? So say that this user changes, right? We're calling set user at some point in the component or anywhere else. That is going to cause a re-render of this this entire user profile component. And as we know, any child of the actual owner component, so profile layout and avatar, are going to re-render because they're part of the user profile component. However, in a different scenario, if profile layout instead had state and it got a re-render, this would not create a re-render of the avatar, even though avatar is technically below profile layout in the tree hierarchy, right? So consider this. We have profile layout, we have the children, again, that is the avatar component. We have some state over here. If this state were to actually change, it would cause a re-render of this profile layout, but the actual children would not re-render. This is something that I feel some developers don't quite get. When you have children over here, I know it's a little bit confusing, but the children don't re-render, even though they are technically, as the article says, below the profile layout. Because you're passing them with children, they're not re-rendering. Cool. So now, how does this tie into React server components? So let's see. Server components are a new type of component in React. The term is confusing here because we've always had the ability to run components on the server in terms of SSR, right? Server-side rendering. We would run components on the server, at least initially, to generate initial HTML, and then the client would take over. So then, what do we call other kinds of components that we've been writing for years? We're starting to call them client components because they can run on the server, but then they can also run on the client. So if you didn't know, a client component, for example, if you're using Next.js, will also run on the server initially once, but then it's going to get hydrated on the client and the client is going to take over from there. That is going to be a client component. A server component only exclusively runs on the server. By contrast, server components cannot run on the client, they're server only. Exactly what I said. So if you're using server components with Next.js, you might notice that your component tree is server components by default until you specify a client boundary for parts of the subtree. You can specify the client boundary using useClient, right? useClient will then define a boundary that from that point onwards, everything is going to be rendered on a client and is going to be a client component. In a component, and now all of the components below it in the tree are actual client components. Lydia Halley does a great job explaining these kinds of concepts with animations. You're going to be able to find this article on the newsletter and in the description. If you want to look at her post, she's great. Check it out. You have the resources to do that. Now, here's the whole point of this article. The reason why it's important to understand owner versus parent in React is because it will help you understand the new rules for using server and client components together. This is really, really important. There are specific nuances to using client and server components together, and you need to understand why those nuances are there and why those restrictions are in place. And actually thinking about all of this in terms of owner components and client components and parent components is really helpful. Server components don't rehydrate the client. They don't send their component code to the client at all. The results of a server component, HTML and some other metadata, sit on the client statically without your component code being there in the client, right? Therefore, they can't have state or JavaScript events, and there's no concept of re-rendering for them. Because again, there is no component code that goes to the client. You have a server component, it runs on the server, it generates the HTML, and then that component code, the actual JavaScript, is gone. It never makes it to the client. So that's why you can't have state, you can't have re-renders, because there is no actual component on the client in terms of the server component. And that is why server components cannot be owned by client components. This is really important. It is a bit confusing. I get it. It takes a while to really wrap your head around this, but server components cannot be owned by client components. Because if a client component re-rendered on the client, there would be no way to re-render the server component that it owns, right? Going back to here, we had owner components. We said that if any, this user profile is an owner component, if it changes, it is going to re-render all of its the component that it owns, right? If any of these are server components, that cannot work because there cannot be a re-render in an actual server component, right? So that's why there's this limitation there. And this article is going to make this a little bit more clear, right? So see, if we had written the examples like this, where profile layout is a client component owner of avatar, which is a server component, can you see how this would be a problem if problem layout got a re-render on the client? This would conceptually re-render avatar because profile layout is its owner, but since server components cannot be rendered, this is not allowed. So let's look. So here exactly, we have profile layout, this is a client component. And the reason why this is a client component is because it has state, right? This code over here, this entire function, this JavaScript code is going to make it to the client, and that's what it allows it to have state to re-render and all of that. Avatar here is a server component and it is inside inside of this profile layout. Profile layout is owning the avatar component, which is a server component. But here, because this component owns it, we said that if we re-render the component, it is going to re-render the child. This cannot happen because there is no re-rendering inside of here. This is a server component, right? This is only pure HTML at this point. So this cannot happen. This is not allowed. What is actually going to happen, because we have the use client here, we're going to typically put a use client directive. If a client component imports a server component, even though that server component is defined as a server component, if we're using it inside of a client component, it automatically becomes a client component because there's no other way around it. It is physically impossible to have this be a server component if we're putting it inside of a client component, because the state here has to re-render and has to re-render this component. And the only way for this component to re-render is if it is forced to become a server component, a client component, sorry. So that is why when we're talking about use client, right, you put use client here at the top of the file, that is a boundary. You're saying that from this point onwards, everything that we import, everything that is a child of this profile layout component, is going to be forced to become a server component, because this is where our client starts. It is not contrary to what some developers believe. When you put use client, it only affects the current page. It's not that. It creates a boundary, and you're saying that from this point onwards, everything is in the client, even if it is defined as a server component, because again, it is physically impossible for this to be a server component, because it has to re-render, because this state over here, profile layout, is its owner, right? So now you can see owner components, server components, they're starting to make sense. And this concept is actually really important. So then what can we do? Well, let's see. If you need to render a server component under a client component, so just like we had done here from a DOM perspective, you can do that, but you have to rearrange who owns what, right? So again, owner components, really important concept. In other words, you have to make the server component, user profile, own avatar, and pass it in as children to the client components. So here we have user profile. Now user profile is a server component, right? It doesn't have state. All of this code never makes it to the client. It's just the actual HTML that this code generates that makes it to the client. We're getting the user here because we can do that. We can run functions on the server. Then we have the profile layout component, which is a client component, right? It has the same state variable over here. And then we're passing avatar here inside of profile layout as its child. The avatar is no longer owned by the profile layout, but is instead owned by the user profile. The profile layout component just receives children and passes it here like this, right? And the avatar component is still a server component. This is going to work. This is allowed. Because just like in the previous example at the beginning of this article, when we said that this re-render, if profile layout was to re-render, the children would not re-render, the same concept applies here. We can pass a server component as a child of a client component without breaking the client server boundary, right? This is kind of a hack, if you will, but it functions using the same mechanism that has been in React all along, right? Children do not re-render when passed directly as children of components, right? A parent will not re-render its children, only the owner will re-render its children. So in this case, we have no problem. We can have profile layout. This can re-render as many times as it wants. It doesn't really care. The children here are not going to get re-rendered, which means that we can safely pass a server component and we can have the avatar remain a server component, even though it is technically, from a DOM perspective, under the profile layout component, right? It is a bit confusing. It takes a bit, again, a while to wrap your head around, but this is a really, really important concept because that's how you can define a proper structure, proper boundary between your client and server components in your applications. Said another way, only server components can pass props into server components, which we see above. When a server component passes props to server components, this happens on the server before the HTML is ever created, right? Then when profile layout rehydrates on the client, because in this case, that is the only component that actually gets into JavaScript on the client, it can have state and it can have re-renders outside of and not blocking and not interfering with everything that happens on the server. Is the term unofficial? I noticed that the React docs don't use owner very often, and sometimes they use parent in places that owner could have been used. That is actually unfortunate because this is already very confusing, especially for new developers. The React docs should at least get this right and should own, no pun intended, the owner component term. I wish the term was more embraced officially because distinguishing between owner and parent really helps articulate what's happening in React better. And I know my audience in workshops can understand more complex React concepts when I explain owner, and then we can use that term conversationally, right? So this is very important, right? I hope that now you've understand owner components, and I hope that this clears up, first of all, how React works under the hood in terms of re-renderers, but also how server components work and how they fit into generally what React is. Every now and then, I see the term owner being used, so I hope that when you see it, you'll have a better idea of what is being explained. Actually, at one point recently, I just looked and opened up the search here, and I saw its article. There it is, right? This is the article, React Owner Components, July 24, 2024. This article is actually one of the first steps into bringing back this concept of owner components, and it's good because now when you search owner components on Google, yes, you get this result from 2015, but you also get this result from 2024, which, you know, is a good thing. We're going in the right direction. So there you go. That was the article. It was very interesting. I really hope that you've learned something from this. And I really hope that now you have a little bit more understanding as to what an owner and a parent is, and also how server components work, right? So again, you can find this link in the description, or you can find it in a newsletter that is delivered completely for free in your inbox every single week. It's called Import Direct, and you can find it in the description. If you enjoyed this video and you want to see more videos just like this one, make sure to leave this video a big thumbs up. You can also click here to subscribe, or you can click here to watch a different video of mine that YouTube seems to think that you're really going to enjoy. And with that being said, my name has been Darius Kozdan. This is Kozdan Solutions. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Ciao, ciao.